Hi everybody, David Dilling from Mark Square, and like many in the graphic arts, we've been testing out this new Affinity Publisher. I have to admit, it's kind of interesting. Okay, so what I'm going to show you now is this Affinity Publisher. I'm going to finish Affinity Publisher in one of the recent files I created over a weekend on a video I made, and that's this one right here. And you see it has, you know, a cutout image here, and it's got some musical note images. It's got fonts, which are actually individual font boxes for the most part. Positioning some other text over here and logo. So what I did, I created a PDF. Now we're going to see how that converts with a click, this Affinity Publisher file with one click right into Adobe InDesign, using PDF as a medium in Marchverse PDF DTP. Okay, let's go check it out. Alrighty, so here we are over on the MacBook Pro, Adobe InDesign CC 2019. And up top in the menu item, you'll see the Marks for menu item for PDF DTP. There's a host of preferences you can get into, and that might affect conversion quality depending on what you have on or off. You know, sometimes if there's too many elements, this might, you know, create a bad conversion. If there's not too many, this is fine. These type of small things. In any event, in theory, right out of the box, most of the time just use PDF DTP by going PDF DTP, convert PDF, and it's that simple. And then we're going to go select that PDF we just created, or I created a couple days ago, and you'll see it here. We just click open, and we can now convert this PDF, all native elements, right into InDesign, just as it was in Affinity Publisher earlier, as you saw on the screen. So we get all the links, we get images exported out of the PDF and saved out into another folder, and we get all the text. If we resize it, you'll see we get the font right there. And you'll see if we go into the font, we'll get the exact font just as it was used in Affinity. And like I mentioned, I think in the other video, these were all individual text boxes, so we have to resize them all. And we get exactly more or less what we had in Affinity. We get the frog image over here. We get the frog image over here. They are exported at the size used. So that's the only drawback to this, is there you see it. The frogs got cut in half because that's all the only thing that was used in the file. So it's actually okay in theory. The logo. So what you see is this is a great, quick and easy way to get your Affinity Publisher files right into InDesign with all the elements converted, even with live text in most cases, and everything right there for you. And yeah, I forgot about the sound. The sound of frogs at night. Lovely sound it is. And this was over here a little bit, wasn't it? Right, something like that. Anyway, just our quick little tip today for those dabbling with Affinity Publisher, or having customers that are dabbling and say, hey, make something even more professional out of this in Adobe InDesign. You can convert your Affinity Publisher files right into Adobe InDesign using PDF as a medium and Mark Squares, PDF to DTP.